there is a story that I have screamed for horror films, but it was a one-off occasion. It doesn't mean that I don't like to scream, though, because I do. I don't know why, but people have often stared at me.
Yes, it's not a new thing.
It's not new at all, and I guess I've just got used to it now. It doesn't bother me at all, and sometimes it makes people laugh, I think. You know, I mean, I know because they have laughed at me, but if I'm feeling strong that day, it doesn't bother me at all.
First of all, a lot of people in the press thought it was a put-on. That anyone would have this kind of style. But if you get a bit into her background and get into a bit of her thought process, you find it's very, what's the word? It's very her, you know. She does believe that anyone can do anything, and she doesn't analyze things too greatly, which I think is a good idea. Yeah. I just realized I've got two pencils here, haven't I?
It's not true at all that Stiff have made up our characters and we are people playing out these roles. We are just how we are naturally. That's the reality of it. And because we're different, people think that we're making it up, but it's just natural. We are like we are. When I first came to England, I settled in Yorkshire, where my mother's from, and Les was also from the same town, so we knew each other then. Things were fine for a while, and then I felt unhappy at home, and I wanted to leave. So I applied to art school.
We started playing together at college. I was playing guitar and mandolin. Len was playing the fiddle. We used to do a lot of busking and things like that, and fringe theatre.
It's been a very busy year for us. And really, up until 1 year ago, Les hadn't even been on an airplane before. So we've travelled a lot in 1 year. I dislike naming names and places and facts in my songs, only because I'm not really interested that people read my life experiences into these songs. I treat them just as stories that people can make what they will of them. Half the fun and enjoyment is to make your own story as you're listening to the music. My story is my story, but there may also be other stories. It's called Home. My name is Yugoslav. It was my grandfather who was from Yugoslavia. And my mother's from Yorkshire, from Hull. And she met my father during the war. And I was born in America. My life has been split almost totally in half, that I've spent half of my life in America and half in England. On paper, on passport, I'm American. But I've never really felt very at home in one particular country. I don't like where I live. And I'm glad to be on tour a lot because I don't have to go back there. And maybe one day I find a nice place to live. I know that I don't look like other people. I know that. But I'm not dressing up for that effect. Whatever I do is natural to me. I don't think we are theatrical. I know other people think we are, and I can understand why people say that, but what I wear is what I wear normally, so I'm not really making a costume. I don't calculate that I must get a reaction from other people. I am what I am, and I do what I do, but what reaction occurs is not that desperate to me. So I would be like this if I was living on an island all by myself. Silence! what I do on stage is what I feel natural to do. It's not really to act out the story, but it's just the tensions that my body goes through when I'm telling the story.
Lovich, der bekannte Rockstar, ist eine seltsame Erscheinung, verrückt und wild. Hier ihre letzte Platte, Birdsong.
I have an idea, a momentary inspiration, a word somebody says, or something that I wake up thinking about. It's a little inspiration that we decide to build on, and it becomes a story. Who knows where your ideas come from? They just come. The idea of birdsong came to me as a result of waking up one morning with a particular emotion. It's not that I had literally dreamed the exact story, but I felt as I must try to describe this feeling, and it was then that the story came out. When I sing, I don't always include conventional singing of words of melody, but more interesting are the sounds that you can make. I think the sounds contribute to an emotional feeling. We do a lot of wild singing just to sing the emotion of it, not to sing a particular tune, but sing the emotional feeling of it. I have had experiences where I see somebody, I know I don't know them, not really. I mean, I've never met them in this life, but I feel an affinity with that person, and I don't really know why. I think it's possible that I'm recalling experiences of the past, or maybe the future, or maybe some other location. Maybe I can communications from other parts of the world. I don't know. There has been times in the past when I haven't been able to cope with it so well, and those situations have been frightening, too frightening for me, because I don't like to think I was out of control. I never really think about putting stops now on my mental activity, because I feel perfectly aware of being able to handle what my imagination or my mind sees. I often think that the reason why we're not able to remember more about the past is because it's obvious that it's not good survival for the future to know too much about what's happened before. Because otherwise you may dwell too much in the past and you may not be able to function very properly in this life. One song is called Sleeping Beauty, and normally when we're on stage, I dedicate it to all the people who have recently died, because I like to think if any spirit is still hanging around, that they might listen to the words of the song, and it might encourage them to pass on and find themselves a new body. Say, open up your eyes, you sleeping beauties must arise. Take me, make me pretty, make me more successful, make me more fortunate, make me more lucky, make me better opportunities for the next life.